Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you Dolf Tchebyshev Array with great details. Before I start with explanation, let me show you how many things that I'm going to cover in this video. See, first of all, I'll be discussing about basics of Dolf Tchebyshev Array. After that, I'll explain you how to identify electric field for given Dolf Tchebyshev Array. After that, I'll explain you Tchebyshev Polynomial. See, designing of Dolf Tchebyshev Array that is happening based on Tchebyshev Polynomial. So here I'll be explaining you how to identify Tchebyshev Polynomial, and at last I'll explain you designing process of Dolf Tchebyshev Array. So after watching this video, you will be able to design Dolf Tchebyshev Array. Let us start this video with first agenda, that is basics of Dolf Tchebyshev Array. Dolf Tchebyshev Array is used to optimize radiation mechanism of antenna array. Here we optimize radiation mechanism by optimizing side lobes. See, with Dolf Tchebyshev Array, we have optimal radiation with side lobes. Here all the side lobes have maximum equal radiation. You can observe here we have main lobe and these are the side lobes. So with side lobes, at max radiation is equal over here, because of which you will be having higher radiation with major lobe. If you have higher radiation with side lobes, then it will be receiving higher interference. But if you have equal at max radiation with side lobes, then you will be having higher power with major lobe, which will be having higher directivity, right? So here in Dolf Tchebyshev Array, we have optimal radiation with its side lobes, because of which you will be having higher directivity with major lobe. With Dolf Tchebyshev Array, we have linear array. Linear array means here all the elements are separated by equal distances. If you observe here, we have even number of elements with Dolf Tchebyshev Array, and here we have odd number of elements with Dolf Tchebyshev Array. Spacing between two elements is equal over here, means here we have linear array. See, Dolf Tchebyshev Array is in phase array. In phase array means all the elements are having same phase. So here, see, with even number of elements or in odd number of elements, you will be having equal phase in between element, right? So phase difference in between element is zero over here. So these three points are very essential. One should know this. See, Dolf Tchebyshev Array, that we use it to optimize side lobes. It is linear array and it is in phase array. Dolf Tchebyshev Array is having better current weightage compared to binomial array. See, in my last video, I have explained binomial array. Binomial array is having non-uniform current distribution. This Dolf Tchebyshev Array, that is also having non-uniform current distribution with different element. But with Dolf Tchebyshev Array, we have better current weightage compared to binomial array. That even I'll explain you by one example. In next video, I'll be solving one problem by which you will get to know how Dolf Tchebyshev Array is having better current weightage compared to binomial array, right? See, its current distribution is based on Tchebyshev polynomial. So in this video, I'll be explaining you how to form polynomial using Tchebyshev polynomial as well. Now I'll be going to explain you electric field calculation with Dolf Tchebyshev Array. To identify electric field of Dolf Tchebyshev Array, first of all, you need to know whether number of elements are even or odd. Here I'll be explaining you electric field calculation for even number of elements as well as for odd number of elements. Let me explain you first what will happen with even number of elements. If you observe, see, here we have even number of elements. In total, 8 elements are there. So, but obviously, origin will be there at center. So here at center, we have origin and we are radiating in this direction right now, which is making angle theta over here. So what will be phase difference in between two consecutive element? Phase difference in between two consecutive element, that will be sine, and that is beta d cos theta plus alpha. where d is spacing between two elements, beta is 2 pi by lambda. So beta is 2 pi by lambda, d is spacing between two element, and this theta, that is direction of radiation. With Dolf Tchebyshev array, we have in phase array that I have told you. See, with Dolf Tchebyshev array, we have in phase array. So here, value of alpha, that is 0, right? So phase difference in between two consecutive element, that is 2 pi by lambda into d into cos theta, that is sine. Now, if you carefully observe, here we have origin. And with respect to origin, towards this side, we have four elements, and towards this side, we have four elements. So as if you want to write electric field, then see total electric field, that will be always super multiple of 2. If you talk about A naught, then 2 into A naught into cos of psi by 2. Why psi by 2? The reason is, here phase with respect to center is psi by 2 with respect to A naught. If you talk about A1, then here we have two elements with A1. So 2 times of A1 into cos of 3 psi by 2. See, with respect to origin, this much phase is psi by 2 and this much is psi. So psi plus psi by 2, that is 3 psi by 2. Similarly, with A2, we have two elements. So 2 times of A2 into cos of pi psi by 2. And with A3, we will be having 2A3 into cos of 7 psi by 2. That is how we can identify electric field equation for even number of elements. If you talk about odd number of elements, then origin is having center element, that is having magnitude as per 2A0. After that, if you observe, we have A1, A1, A2, A2, that is how elements are there in pair, right? So if you want to identify electric field, then ET will be, see here, this 2A0, that is there at origin, so there is no phase. So you can say 2A0 only. Then A1, that is having two elements, so I'm writing 2A1, and here phase is psi over here with respect to origin. So cos of psi. Then we have A2. A2 is having phase of 2 psi. And pair of A2 is there. So 2 times of A2 into cos of 2 psi. That is how we can form equation. Here with A3, we have pair of A3. So we have 2A3 into cos of, here phase is 3 psi. Right. So that is how one can form equation of electric field. So here one thing that you need to understand, in case of even number, see, origin will be over here at center, and with respect to A naught, here phase is psi by 2, and then with next element it will be 3 psi by 2, then with next element it will be 5 psi by 2, and so on. You can calculate phase. While with odd numbers, origin will be there on the element, where on this element magnitude will be 2A0. See, this magnitude A0, A1, A2, A3, that one can calculate based on Tchebyshev polynomial. So first of all, you need to understand how to identify Tchebyshev polynomial. Let me explain that. Tchebyshev polynomial is used to identify weightage of elements in Dolf Tchebyshev array. If you observe Dolf Tchebyshev array, then here we have different elements. With different elements, weightage is A0, A1, A2, A3. To identify these values, you need to know Tchebyshev polynomial. Let me explain you how Tchebyshev polynomial is there. See, Tchebyshev polynomial with order m is explained as per Tm of x, that is cos of m cos inverse of x. Here, value of x that is there in between plus or minus 1 means mod of x is less than 1. Here, see this cos inverse x, that is delta, and that is also psi by 2. Psi is phase difference in between consecutive element that I have explained, that is 2 pi by lambda into d into cos theta, where d is spacing between two elements, theta is angle of radiation. Here, based on cos inverse x is equals to delta, you can say x is equals to cos delta. Now I'll explain you how to identify different order of Chebyshev polynomial. If you want to calculate zeroth order of Chebyshev polynomial, then m is equals to zero in that situation. See, here we will be having cos of m into delta, that you can say means cos m delta, right? So here m is zero, so you can say cos of zero, that is one. If you want t1 of x, then m is equals to one inside, so cos m of delta, that will be now cos of delta only, and cos delta is x, so you can say this Chebyshev polynomial is x. If you want t2 of x, then cos of 2 cos inverse x, or you can say cos of 2 delta. So cos of 2 delta is how much? Cos of 2 delta is 2 cos square delta minus 1. Cos delta is x, so you can say this order 2 is 2x square minus 1. Now if you want t3 of x, then here t3 of x is cos of 3 delta. Cos 3 delta equation, that is giving you 4x cube minus 3x. Now if you want t4x onwards, then you need to use simple equation. Let me explain you how. For t4x onwards, we need to use tm plus 1 of x, that is equals to 2x into tm of x minus tm minus 1 of x. This is what the equation that you need to use for t4x onwards. Let me give you one example. If you want to calculate t4 of x, then that will be 2x into t3 of x minus t2 of x. Here t3 of x that we have calculated, that is 4x cube minus 3x minus t2 of x, that is 2x square minus 1. So this is 2x into 4x cube, that is resulting into 8x cube, 2x minus 3x, that is minus 6x square minus 2x square, that is minus 8x square, and minus minus plus 1. That is how one can identify further polynomials, right? I hope you have understood how to have Chebyshev polynomial. Now I'll explain you designing process of Dolf Tchebyshev array. To design Dolf Tchebyshev array, there are few interesting steps that you need to follow. Let me explain you how. See, in first step, you need to identify value of small r. See, small r is side lobe level ratio, means it is a ratio of main lobe to side lobe. If it is given in terms of dB, then you'll have to use equation of 20 log r. So first of all, you need to identify value of small r, that is side lobe level ratio. If you observe radiation pattern, see, here we have electric field, so in that this is maxima of major lobe and this is maxima of side lobes, right? This is maxima of side lobes. So ratio of maxima of major lobe to maxima of side lobe, that is side lobe level ratio, that will be given to you in designing, and based on that you can identify the value of small r. In second step, you need to identify value of x naught. See, x naught can be calculated based on Chebyshev polynomial, and Chebyshev polynomial that can be identified based on number of elements. So here, as if I say we have been given with number of elements, that is small n, then based on that, one can identify degree of Tchebyshev polynomial. Degree of Tchebyshev polynomial is m, and that is n minus 1, where n is number of elements in array. So once you have number of elements, you can identify Tchebyshev polynomial's degree. And based on that, you can identify Tchebyshev polynomial as well. What is Tchebyshev polynomial? Tchebyshev polynomial, that is Tm of x, that you can identify. And based on this, you can identify the value of x naught. But that calculation is a bit tedious. So I request you to remember one equation by which you can directly identify the value of x naught. See, if you want to calculate value of x naught, then that can be calculated by equation of half of in bracket r plus square root of r square minus 1 raised to 1 by m plus in bracket r minus square root of r square minus 1 raised to 1 by m. If you calculate this, then you will be getting value of x naught. This is easier way compared to the way by which you will be calculating this Tchebyshev polynomial, right? By direct equation, one can identify this, where small r, that is based on side lobe level ratio, and this m is degree of Tchebyshev polynomial, that is n minus 1, where n is number of elements, right? In third step, we need to identify equation of electric field. See, electric field equation, that you can identify based on even number of element and odd number of element. If you have even number of element, then this is what the basic equation that you'll have to follow. I have told you with respect to origin, A naught is having phase of psi by 2, A1 is having phase of 3 psi by 2, and you just need to do algebraic sum of all elements. In odd number, this middle element that is there on the origin, so 2a0 plus, now a1 is having phase of psi, so 2a1 cos psi, a2 is having phase of 2 psi, so 2a2 cos 2 psi. That is how you'll have to apply rules for a calculation of electric field. So in third step, you need to identify electric field polynomial over here, and based on that, one can identify fourth step. And in fourth step, we need to identify weightage of elements. See, in third step, we are dealing to identify electric field. And in fourth step, we are dealing to identify weightage. And that weightage, that can be calculated by comparing electric field with Tchebyshev polynomial. By this comparison, we will be having weightage of coefficients. And based on weightage of coefficients, we will be having complete Dolf Tchebyshev array along with weightage of individual elements. So these are the basic steps that you'll have to follow. And in next video, I'll be taking one problem by which you will be able to understand how exactly we can easily calculate designing of Dolf Tchebyshev array. I hope you have understood this. Still, if anything that you'd like to share, just note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.